Well, you've just seen the streets of Jakarta at night. Well, I tell you, you haven't seen anything until you come inside in Jakarta to the Istora Senayan, because once again we have an extraordinary atmosphere developing for a home tie. It will be Indonesia versus Germany in just a couple of moments. And I know you'll want to hang on to your hats here, because it is an extraordinary experience. We've been going through this for the last 5 days now. We've got still some fabulous action, because we're at the semi-final stage of the UBE Cup tonight. We've already experienced China versus Korea. China going through 3-1 against Korea into the finals. It's raining outside. I just poked my head out to find out what it was like in the real world. I came straight back in, because this is where you'd want to be right now. 73% humidity outside. It's 100% very, very big humid action here, because it is going to be absolutely intense. Germany versus Indonesia in the UBE Cup, and Indonesia fancy their chances of getting through to the final. It's going to be a real battle. We've still got about another 12 and a half minutes before the actual match, or the presentation of the teams, comes about. But you can hear probably in the background the music, the building up of the tension in the crowd, because they are responding, as we expect them to, with some extraordinary displays of patriotism. The Indonesians and badminton are synonymous. The Indonesians with winning at badminton, well, watch out, they're difficult to stop. It's going to be a great battle, and I think the team that they've lined up here today after their display yesterday will absolutely have a superb chance of victory. We're still keeping at the moment another 11 minutes left up our sleeves before we get the display. But let's have a look in just a couple of moments at the lineup, and there it is. Well, in fact, in the qualifying, the Indonesian team beat Japan 4-1. They beat the Netherlands 5-0. And in the quarterfinal against Hong Kong, they didn't have much trouble there either. 3-0. They only have the best of five in the latter stages. Germany, however, well, they lost to China. Thank you, Jill. The atmosphere building, although you can't see the seats filled at that end of the court, let me tell you, where we are, right above the court at the moment, we certainly are in an advantageous position right above all the action, and these seats are filled right around us here. In fact, so much so, you will forgive us if we do shout from time to time, because that's all we have to hear. The shouting and the screaming around us. Look at this. The scenes of national pride are there for all to see. A little lull in proceedings gives me the chance to suggest, a little bit of a yawn there, young man. Come on, wake up. You're about to witness another major, major milestone in Indonesian badminton history. They haven't actually been in this position in the UBF Cup since Hong Kong. In fact, they got runners-up to China. China have dominated the UBF Cup since they came into it in 1984. But Indonesia were runners-up in 98, so 10 years ago when they took on China in Hong Kong. Since then, they've never actually got into a final, although previous to that, they've actually won it on three occasions.
Just a quick shot there of Christian Hedinata, of course, former world champion, great player that he was, played and won here in Jakarta, as we're looking at Susie Susanti on the left, the first ever Olympic champion in women's singles in Barcelona in 1992. Christian Hedinata, of course, he won two world titles in this very stadium way back in 1980, men's doubles and mixed doubles as well. And he has been imparting his knowledge ever since then to the Indonesian players.
One little aside here, Jill. You played in Barcelona in 92. I was commentating in Barcelona in 92. We weren't even on the commentary scene in those days, but I tell you what, it was a thrilling game. I absolutely adored it. Fabulous time. And Susie Susanti, I can't believe it's 16 years ago. Can you?
No, just extraordinary.
Indonesia, you'll hear the cry. You'll hear them shout for the Indonesian team as they're about to play the shuttle. They will boo the opposition. It's all good fun. It's great, great style here. And we are thrilled to be able to bring it to you very shortly. That's what it's all about. The one on the right is the UBEAR Cup, the UBEAR Trophy. China have won it 10 times. Japan have won it 5. Indonesia, as I mentioned before, have won it 3 times. But not have they been in this position since... in fact, 96, 10 years since they had a chance of carrying it away. We have a very, very electric atmosphere here inside the Istora Senayan. Betty Huber, the founder of this competition and the presenter of the Huber Cup, back in 1956-57 in Great Britain, in Lancashire, in fact, the place of her birth, would be absolutely tickled at the moment to see all this celebration. This is what the fun, the fuss is about. A most wonderful... Yes, and there I am! I'm on screen as well, good lad. It must be such a thrill to leave such a lasting legacy. Just about 5 minutes to go before we're up and running. Germany, as we saw earlier, did have a very interesting battle, and against the USA they were undefeated, and against South Africa and Denmark, which was a little bit surprising for me. I didn't realize they would be so strong and give the Danes such a hiding.
No, that's right. I think as far as Denmark is concerned in the women's disciplines, the Scandinavian country is struggling at the moment. They, of course, a few years ago had the great Camilla Martin, and now they're having huge success with Tina Rasmussen winning the All England Championships earlier this year. But beyond that, they really haven't got the strength in depth. And Germany, all credit to them, because they came out for the quarterfinal. Of course, they weren't seeded to win. Germany, just the number 6 seeds here at the UBEAR Cup, and Denmark were, I think, probably expected to beat them and get through.
Their near neighbours, the Netherlands, have done a fantastic job as well. In fact, they came so close last evening to upsetting the favourites.
They certainly did, and the Netherlands against China, that quarter-final, as I was explaining about the order of play for tonight's semi-final, it was played in the unusual order of three singles first, because of course the players from the Netherlands, there was two players from the Netherlands that were playing twice, down on the schedule to play twice, just as Juliana Schenk is doing this evening. And therefore they played the three singles first of all, and in the second women's singles, Judith Mellendijk's held a match point against Lu Lan of China. And had she converted that, of course, the Netherlands won the first singles and the third singles, and it could have been a sensation. It could have been China out.
Well, ifs and maybes and haves and buts are not counting anymore. It's all now about the future. There is huge pressure on this Indonesian team. You wouldn't want to be in their shoes right now, I can tell you. Yulianti Perisari, Novita Puli, Zebadia, Natsira Marissa. Wow. Your heart.
would bother me slightly, because they're just enjoying the party. There's some serious work to do first.
There's serious work, but if they can do it with freedom of expression,
yep,
and enjoyment that they obviously are going to try to do, this is quite an extraordinary... For the first time in the history of the Uber Cup, the Germans have a little parade. It's the train from Germany coming into the centre for a little huddle. And now, I'm sure, after the fun and games, oh, they've wound up the Indonesian crowd very successfully here. Yeah, and I can tell you what, they won't be taking a train home if they win this. They'll be going by rocket ship. There will come a time when we'll settle down to a very, very interesting match. But for the moment, we're just sucking in the atmosphere, breathing in the air, and oh, just to counter things. Hello, what have we got? What a party. What a festival.
And even Susie Susanti is joining the team. Of course, she is the team manager here of the Uber Cup, of the Indonesian squad, and what experience she's bringing.
You know, Jill, I've got a lump in my throat. Can you hear me? I've got a lump in my throat. Such emotion before this match gets going. What on earth is going to happen if they get through to the final? I've told all my friends I'm the luckiest granddad on the planet to be here. They don't believe me. I hope if they watch this, they will. Look at that crowd, they're standing, they can't sit, they're so excited. The players area, you can see right in front of us, middle center screen. And now, the business of the night. Zhu Huiwen, she can't help but smile either, can she? Look at that! Maria Christin waves to the crowd as well. It's infectious, you can't avoid it. How serious can you be? So hard to be serious. They will remember this their whole lives. The experience of the 32-year-old Zhu Huiwen. And as Jill said, the European champ. She also won the Swiss Open in 2006. But the gold medalist this year. She has been there and done it. Born in China, of course, but now representing Germany. What a stage. What a match in prospect.
Yes, it certainly is. This matchup, well, Zhu Huiwen, as you just mentioned, born in China, but moved to Germany back in 2000 and trains at the National Training Center in Saarbrücken. Interesting family background, because of course her father was a volleyball player, her mother a basketball, and she was born and brought up in a sports school in China, in Chengdu, of course.
Well, that's entirely appropriate that we mentioned that, Jill. Obviously our hearts and our thoughts go out to the people of Chengdu, particularly, and all the disasters that are befalling that area, that province at the moment. It is just inconceivable that the fun, the excitement and the great celebration we're experiencing here in Jakarta could be offset by the tragedy, the human tragedy that's besetting the people of China. And our hearts and condolences go out to those people in China today and forever. 25 ranked in the world then is Marie-Christine Julianti. And she is going to be up against a very experienced campaigner. She's never beaten her on three occasions previous to this. So it is going to be a huge challenge for the youngster. 22-year-old, yeah, sorry.
Yeah, so, I mean, she hasn't won any of their previous three encounters. The first time they played each other was way back in 2003. I think we can sort of ignore that because it was so long ago then, and the Indonesian player was so young at the time. And even the last time they played was 18 months ago, and that was in Germany. So it was very much suiting Zhu Wei when she had her home fans. So as far as I'm concerned, you might as well ignore the previous head-to-heads. Of course, they're important, but here is the first experience of the Indonesian having the home fans' support up against Zhu Aiwen, and I think that's going to make a big difference.
It definitely is. It's number 8 in the world, but I think world rankings will go out of the window here at the Istora Senayan. The rankings, forget them. It's the now, it's the here, and it's the pressure of the match. They've had their smiles, they've had their celebrations. Now the serious business of concentration, focus, take in what the coach has said, and now put into it your own unbelievable talent and belief in yourself, because that's what will carry this young girl, Maria Kristin, through. Belief that she can. Oh, this is great.
Right,
I love it.
Germany,
that's why we're here. Wong Shui Yin of Hong Kong is our match official. She can't be heard. I hope you can lip read. Here we go then. First point of the first match of the semi-final of the UEFA Cup 2008. It was left, it was in. I guess we could talk about the drift. It certainly is that way. One all.
One all.
Yes, we've mentioned the fact that Zhu Aiwen is European champion. In fact, she's been European champion for the last two championships. It's an event that's only played once every other year, but she's also twice been bronze medalist in the World Championships. And there really is a gulf of experience from what they've achieved so far. But as we've just been discussing, I think you can just throw that out of the window. This is completely different circumstances, different pressures.
That's a fantastic drop shot immediately from Maria Kristin. And she takes a 2-1. Much you can say really, except the crowd are playing every shot. 2-2. And she will not open her mouth until the coach speaks to her. Her breathing control is unbelievable. We mentioned it yesterday, Jill, the fact that they can't hear the strike of the shuttle will be significant. They will not be able to hear the power and the drop shot, even more importantly.
Yeah, that's right, and players do rely, you know, on hearing the racket hit the shuttle. It's part of the timing, it's part of the feel of the shot. And you can't hear it, it really is very disconcerting.
They've got to ignore what's going on around them, which must be the most difficult task yet set them. Just wide. It will drift from left to right as we see our overview camera. We've seen it throughout the competition, and this time Maria Kristin Well, I hope she learns from that, because that's what happens. It's stimulus and response, isn't it, in good players.
We discussed it yesterday with the Indonesian players, this easy, relaxed hitting style, and just the whole style adds to part of the deception, because, you know, there's no big build-up, you can't tell whether it's a smash or a drop, whether it's going cross or straight.
Not too far off a brilliant shot, but I went... is still hanging in here, and in fact has taken the lead at 5-4. If you have to have a player to lead off your team, she's the girl.
Absolutely. She is such a fighter on court. She's a terrific athlete. Physically, she's so competent. She's compact, she's strong, she's fast, and she will never give up on a match. There she is, Zhu Aiwen, and you're absolutely right. If you want a player to lead out a team and give effort, then you wouldn't want better. You couldn't find better than Zhu Aiwen. She will give it everything.
It's in. It's a superb race. It was a deep shot, but it wasn't even close to the line. It was well in, and Aiwen will be a bit disappointed at that misjudgment. Again, you don't know what comes out of the crowd in terms of the impulse. Maybe she thought it was struck a much, much harder than in fact it was. It's 6-5, Indonesia. 7-5. You know, we could almost be redundant in this match, because the crowd will tell the whole story.
Absolutely.
It's out. It's a brilliant lead.
Very, very interesting in that rally from the Indonesian player. 9 shots she hit to the back of the court. She only played 2 to the front. She's basically trying to keep the German pinned to the back, get her out of position, and then only bring her forward. She was off balance.
It's 6-8, but it's an intriguing battle of youth versus experience. 10 years between them in terms of experience, but by golly, they're absolutely neck and neck in terms of the quality of their play.
And the Indonesian, well, she's looking very, very calm and collected at the moment. And as much as the player representing Germany is concerned, as hard as she's trying, she does look a little rattled to me, and that's understandable. Frankly, she's not just playing an opponent, she's playing the whole crowd as well.
7-9.
It's 7-9. I beg your pardon, I was watching another scoreboard just now. 7-9, Germany. Oh, opens it up, but still Marie-Christine gets into great shape. Wow, fantastic point that, Jill.
It certainly was. She commanded the rally as UI went, and the commitment coming forward, that was only a half chance. And she's sent a message to her opponent by the way she played that kill. She said, right, I'm going to go for things, you've got to be aware of me. If she'd been half-hearted and played an X shot, it would have been a totally different message, but she's thrown down the gauntlet now. That was the one.
About 10 minutes, I guess, into this game at the moment, and at 8-9, it's as tight as we'd hoped. It's short, it's 9-all, the German bench is on its feet.
Yeah, the opportunity was there for Marie-Christine. Zhu Aiwen was way back in court. She didn't have to make it that tight. All she had to do was get it over and in. And I just wonder about that previous rally and the message that went out from the German. Whether that's intimidated the Indonesian playing net shots.
Wow, that's got to be four in a row. So it was 6-9 you told me earlier. It's now 10-9. So there's a little bit of anxiety in the crowd. Unbelievable pickups there by the Indonesian. That's a great clear. Wow, for nothing. Was under pressure for most of that rally, having to pick up everything. Staying in the rally was one thing, but then coming up with a fabulous clear to the backhand backcourt. 10-all, how about that?
Again from Zhu Aiwen, when she's getting the half opportunity to come forward, she is not holding back. She's going in so quickly. The power smash, look, she's moving already. And in for the kill. That's great commitment.
She's athletic, she's energetic, she's determined, and she's in the lead by 11-10 at the halfway point of this opening game. In the second semi-final of the Uber Cup here in Jakarta. And the German girl, Zhu Aiwen, will be very pleased to be in this position at the moment.
Hinderwan, former world champion, imparting advice. He's the one with the baseball cap on. World champion in Seville in 2001, Hinderwan.
The crowd will always find something to cheer or to boo about. But at the moment, I tell you, it is a fascinating battle unfolding. Well, we've heard a new sound in the audience at 11-all. It's a drum that beats the shot that Zhu Aiwen actually plays. I'm not so sure whether it's going to be helping her or hindering, but listen out for it. It's a snare drum.
She's making errors now on her blocks and her net shots, Marie-Christine. And that's because of those, is it two or three occasions now that Zhu Aiwen has come storming forward to the net and made the kill. Now the Indonesian is feeling she's got to hit the perfect shot, otherwise it's going to be punished. And because she's trying to make it perfect, she's not giving herself any margin for error.
No, 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 that is outrageous. My goodness me, that is extraordinary. Well, we said she had the experience, but how on earth did she get that back? That's an outrageous shot. And then it's too high, of course, and too high when finishes it. It's 13-11.
That's the sort of shot that can change a match. I know we're only in the first game, the early stages, but even so, that's the sort of shot that gives you so much confidence. Yep, oh, yeah, look at that.
A dummy to perfection. Now you see it, now you don't. Magical qualities from Su Haiwen, 14-11. She was a bit slow in going forward to that one. I think she was still thinking about how good the last shot was.
Yeah, I think she was really expecting the lift in reply to that low serve. But that's good variation from Julianti.
Service over. 15.
Good watching, good observing. She is absolutely into this match. Loving the thought of upsetting the home crowd, maybe. But first and foremost, showing that Europe can take on Asia.
In the very early stages of this opening game, this is what Maria Kristin was doing so well, taking it early at the net and controlling the front of the court. And she got a little bit nervous about doing that because of the kills that have been made by Zhu Aiwen. Now she's beginning to anticipate. And the big key at control at the net is taking the shuttle early, and she did that in that last rally.
She's played some big, big names in the game already, has Julianti. And I tell you, at the World Championship, she lost in the third round to Zhang Ning. But it was a brave effort. She is definitely not going to be overawed here. Look at this. It's fantastic badminton. Tremendous stuff. It's out. It's 14-15. Gillian Clark is applauding together with the whole stadium here.
There was three extraordinary backhands there before the error from Zhu Aiwen. The control initially on the backhand side was out of this world.
A little smile of frustration, but she will appreciate how much her opponent also put into that rally. It was fabulous. It's long, it's 15-all. Oh, look at the smiles in the VIP box. Two wants a change of service. A change of shuttle, should I say. She would love a change of service. She wants a change of shuttle, which is resisted. 15-all. I tell you what, you'd be a brave person, a brave German, to sing Deutschland, Deutschland, Über alles right at this moment, wouldn't you? I think you'd be bobbed. Stunning. Absolutely stunning. Ho-ho! 16-15 Indonesia. What a shot. It caught the top of the net. It was absolute perfection. Millimeter perfect. And look at that little celebration. The youngster is feeling good.
Yes, and I think the significance, 4 straight points for the Indonesian. They come back into the lead. And of course, when you get to the latter stages of a game, it's absolutely vital.
It's short. It's 2 points the difference.
17.
The crowd absolutely going wild. It's only 1 point. You'd think it was the whole cup at stake right here. Extraordinary. Just out.
Service over.
That's a bit of a shame, really, that it's lost on an error like that from the service. But she will persist with that long, long raking high serve. And Zul keeps the short one going. Oh, the drunk did the job there. It actually preempted the hit. And I'm not sure whether it puts two off, but look at that. A little bit of luck is what you need at 17-all. Wow, what a matchup.
Misjudgment there, I think, hoping more than really believing that the shuttle was going to go long.
And a little moment for the crowd to boo, simply because Zul Kaiwen took a little bit of an unscheduled break there, a bit of a towel down. Drink of water.
17.
Yeah, I know she did, but I mean, in this sort of match situation, the humidity we've got here, and both players wanted to have a little time out. But both players agree, I don't really see a problem with it. It's if one player is trying to use his gamesmanship, that's when it's a problem.
18-all.
Kaiwen
took the break. But she hasn't continued with the score. It's gone. It's 19-18. The faces of the people here, you can't believe how thrilled they are to see that point for Indonesia. You just can't help smiling, just looking around you, how excited this crowd is. Assisting down that forehand side. Why is she doing that, Jill?
The reason she's doing it is because Maria Kristen has got this bandaged knee. Yeah, and Susie's a little bit concerned, isn't she? Rightly so. She's, her player had the opportunity to get a game point, but not to be. The reason, when she's lunging deep into that forehand corner, she's landing on that right leg where she's got it bandaged.
Well, that's clever play by Kaiwen then.
Yep.
This time it goes cross-court, it's out, and it's game point to Germany. 20 points to 19. Well, he said you couldn't read much into the runes of the record. 3-0 to Kaiwen, but it's game point at the moment. Oh, it's not done yet. It's still not done. Oh, my goodness. It's still game point. How on earth did that happen? Kaiwen will fight to the death. She's going to have to. What a rally. It's in. It's 20 all. Oh, my goodness. Well, if you're going to play anything back at home, that has to be one of the most extraordinary points. Zhu Huiwen was down and out at the net. She fell over as she played the shuttle. It's now come to deuce at 20s, and I tell you, you won't see a better point.
Yeah, she actually did the splits in the middle of that rally. And it's not only the capability to, and the, you know, the flexibility to be able to do that, but the recovery was so quick. Absolutely extraordinary.
Wow.
Extra points required now, of course, because you need a two clear point winning margin.
Here we go. All over again. The atmosphere is electric. What a pick up by Zhu. She's under enormous pressure as the German, but she just persists to that right hand backcourt. It's out. It's game point once again to Germany.
Oof. 21-20.
And again, Zhu asking for a little towel down. Is that a bit of gamesmanship? Maybe.
I've never done any umpiring, but I would have said no, you can't have a break, not at a game point. I agree with the umpire. I think that's good from her.
Game point. Marie-Christine Juliante has missed the line. And it's 22-20 for Germany in this opening game. The first of the singles in this second semi-final of the Uber Cup. Wow, what excitement. It's the kind of matchup where you think, Jill, you wouldn't mind being here till midnight.
Absolutely. I wouldn't mind being here till 1 o'clock in the morning if we're going to see badminton like this.
German bench have started as they need to go on. There's no doubt about that. They came out with a sort of Gemütlichkeit, they call it. It's a sort of feeling of well-being. Everybody's having fun. It's all good news. But now the serious business of competition is absolutely in focus. The youngster is contributing enormously to the enjoyment. But hey, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter how they do it, they have to win. Win ugly, they say in some circles. I can't necessarily agree with that, but at the moment, it's certainly so entertaining. It's wonderful theatre.
20 seconds. 20 seconds.
Would you do anything differently, Jill?
I would revert back to trying to keep Zhu Huiwen at the back of the court for a little bit longer. If I was the Indonesian coach, I'd be saying, work around the back first before you start bringing her forward.
Second game.
Maria-Christine Juliante facing the serve in the second game. Confidence, yep.
Very much so.
One love.
And just to indicate the intensity of this women's singles encounter, 27 minutes and we've only just started the second game.
It's short. It's just a little lethargic. There's just that millisecond of hesitation.
You So you
either the knee again, yeah.
Yeah, lunging forward or lunging into her forehand corner. She's always landing on that right knee. And with that injury problem, that's what has to be exploited again. I know she's pushed it just wide, but she was making the Indonesian turn. Look at this. She puts the right leg out to try and lunge to play the shot. She didn't need to play it, but that's the pressure on the injury.
You know, there's a spark in Wai Wen's step. She's got the pressure off her shoulders, having taken that first game, and you can tell she's just got a lot more freedom of movement. 3-1. And another fabulous drop, and that's the first time I've seen Maria Kristin actually react negatively. What's her reaction here? She's so upset. Well, we didn't quite get it, but she's very annoyed with herself.
Yeah, and certainly from a tactical point of view, she's lost control of the net. That's nice stuff. Good deception.
Brilliant.
And the thing about a drop shot like that, I know it was an outright winner, but had her opponent got it back, she would have had to play it very, very late indeed. And that then would have given the Indonesian the opportunity to come in and play it early and control the front of the court. Because she's not been doing that.
A good, exciting rally, but it was the ambition of two Wai Wen that led her down there. It was a high-risk strategy. She's puffing a little bit, but I tell you what, she is loving it. You live for these moments, Jill, don't you?
This is why you put in all the hard training to experience things like this. You know, I've been fortunate enough to play in this very special arena as far as badminton is concerned, Astora Stadium. You know, it's the heartland really of badminton, and it really is a fantastic experience. Even if the crowd are on your back, you know, as a player, I loved being in this sort of situation.
Germany. It's out of court, and that is a pressure shot.
Yeah, that's a desperation shot more than anything. She hadn't worked her opponent. She's going for a winner far too early on in the rally, and that's a sign that she's running out of ideas. She doesn't quite know how she's going to win this. Another error.
It's 7-3. The crowd are disappointed.
7-3.
Yeah, your point about body language, the body language there was very negative.
I hope it was a good one.
They've
been very, very good, the line judges, throughout this whole tournament.
Well, I have to say that my instinct when I saw it the first time round in live play, I thought it was wide. I thought it was a good call by the line judge.
The fight back begins. The crescendo is in place. The expectations are now again heavily weighing on Maria Kristin's shoulders. 5-7. She can't allow her opponent to take another game. Oh, what a shame.
It's over.
She did everything. anything but the final execution.
8-5.
Yes, she was in balance. It was the right shot to try. There is no reason why she should make an error there, other than the pressure of the situation.
Instead of 1 point the difference, it's now 3, and in fact that's on the line.
So for
2 points the difference now, 6-8.
6-8.
Next four rallies or so is going to determine this match. Either the Indonesian can get back in this, or Zhu Aiwen's going to pull away. And as a player, you know, sometimes you have to sense these big points. And of course, coaches and us as spectators can look on and say, Craig, look, it's only 6-8 in the second game. Why is these such big points? But they are big points, trust me. It's these next few rallies that really could determine this game.
Well, there's one of them to Indonesia.
7-8.
Momentum is what it's all about.
Yeah, that wasn't even close, was it?
Zhu Aiwen has just had another altercation with umpire Wong Shui-in. Is it going to be changed? Yes, it is. Okay, the shuttle will change.
7-8.
She knows how to win, this girl.
Opponent's court. This is the one. Send the German deep into the back corners, and she won't be able to then clear to the back of the court. You know that the reply has to come back to the net, and you can be waiting for it.
It's 8-all. Ah, it's been an unbelievable shot there, over her head, stretching. But the big, big point. So deep on the forehand side once again of Maria Christine that she couldn't force the response to put pressure on. It's out. Well, you said the next 4 points, but it's gone first of all Indonesia's way, then she's relaxed a little bit, and again this whole issue of momentum and confidence is ebbing and flowing. It's a fascinating battle, mental battle as much as anything else. Huge wristwatch she's wearing as well. A long time.
It was
a great call.
It was a fantastic call by the line judge. Just coming back to your point about the wristwatch on Zhu Aiwen, it's actually recording her heart rate as well. She's wearing a monitor around her chest, and this will all be downloaded onto computer so that she knows what her heart rate has been throughout the duration of the match.
The inside story from Gillian Clark. Well, I tell you what, I could do with a heart rate monitor at the moment to serve Jill.
10-4.
I know that I'm definitely in the upper reaches of the BP. It's 10-all. Well, it's no wonder, is it? Anybody that loves sport as much as we do, they have to get into this. It's extraordinary. has called good. It's right on the line
over.
As they go to the half in this second game.
In the ball.
The German has taken the first game 22-20. She just edges into the lead in the second, 11-10. And that was the most fantastic clear that was left. And Maria Christine will regret that.
Yes, in fact, Zhu Aiwen couldn't have walked over to that end of the court and placed the shuttle any better than she did with that clear. Landed on the interchange between the sideline and the back line. Absolute perfection. The German coach on the right as we look at them. Former Dutch international player himself, Jeroen van Dijk. Now
towering over her. Look at
very much so. He was also incidentally president of the Players Federation. I think he took over from me.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Well, Germany still edging
11-10.
It at the moment. 11-10. Second game.
It's going to be long. This is the thing, you know, we're seeing the final winning shot, which was a terrific angle, but you're absolutely right, John, it was the shot prior to that that set up the rally. Yeah, look, she's keeping her to the back now. Not short.
It's 13-11, and that is an extraordinary achievement, really. She's got 3 points in a row by some clever, clever thinking.
Shot there, I think that might have been going out, but she chose to play it, made the error. And John, wouldn't it be great if we got a deciding game here?
Oh. Help me, help me.
Brilliant. Down the forehand side, then immediately switch with the quick angle chop down the backhand side, making the German twist and turn.
What I cannot understand is how they can possibly play that shot and not have an eye on the shuttle as they do it. It's extraordinary. They've lined it up and then it's all mechanical from then on.
Serve is over.
That's the weakness as far as Maria Christin is concerned. Deep in her forehand corner. Well exploited by the German.
You said that from the opening point, that she would push it way down into that forehand. Still a 3-point cushion for Indonesia.
Oh, my word.
It's out. The court at her mercy, and she puts it long.
15.
That's adrenaline. 13-15. 14-15. What an exceptional shot.
14-15.
She cut right across. Look at that. Wonderful, wonderful decision.
Maria Christin needs to bury the return of serve mode. The German is serving short the whole time, and every time the Indonesian is lifting it to the back of the court. She needs to just mix it up a little bit.
Got a feeling that's four in a row.
Yeah. It is indeed.
We were at 15 all in the first game. We've got the same score right now. Germany have the lead,
5-1,
5 in a row. That's so disappointing for Julianti and the crowd.
It's so extraordinary, though, with such a close match. First of all, the Indonesian winning 5 straight points, and now the German winning 5 straight points, and yet it's a very, very close match. You wouldn't expect those runs of points.
And now 6 in a row as she goes to 17-15, and the crowd don't know what to do. They are cheering more in hope at the moment. They're a bit shell-shocked at what is happening.
Oh, that's going wide.
It could have been long or wide, rather.
It's not clear.
You notice the little spring again into Wai Wen's step. She is bouncing. Oh, yes. 18-15.
The work rate is absolutely extraordinary from this player. You know, you say she's bouncing about. I mean, suddenly there was an intensity with her movement, wasn't there? She'd upped the pace. And when we talk in badminton about upping the pace, it's not always pace of shot. It's pace of movement. And Zhu Wai Wen did that quite brilliantly in that last rally.
Oh, that is 7 in a row.
18,
at the most crucial moment in the match. She's taken the first 22-20. It's 18-15 in the second. 3 points away from a first tie win for Germany. It's in. Wow. 19-15. For the first time in the match, really, we're able to hear ourselves fairly easily, because it's only the Germans who are using those crazy clappers and the drums to cheer.
And what is lovely to see, John, is the fact that the German Thomas Cup squad are all here supporting the Uber Cup team. Not a thought of any German player going back to their home country and watching this on television. They all want to be here supporting. That's terrific to see.
It's out. It's match point to Germany. Maria Christine Julianti. Jill points out to me that it's 9 in a row. Match point. This first time, and the Indonesian crowd are really, really in agony. What a rally. Fantastic, that's it! Germany take the opening tie in this Uber Cup semi-final, Indonesia versus Germany, and the ever, ever faithful and the certainly ever reliable 32-year-old Zhu Wai Wen of Germany takes it as they bow in admiration at the bench. This is the final point, and look at that. That is a 10-point when it matters.
Yes, a run of 10 straight points is absolutely extraordinary in this sort of cauldron of an atmosphere, and all credit to Zhu Wai Wen. You said right at the start that if you wanted a player to lead you out, it'd be Zhu Wai Wen, and as you can see, Germany take the first match in this semi-final tie.
Coming up right after this will be Julian Schenk against Adriani Perdesari. I hope you can't go away, because there's no way we can. The crowd have kept us hemmed in here. Join us in just a while for some more great Uber Cup action.